It's been crazy having so many people working on Lobato.
There's a lot of pops in this cutscene.
Yeah.
A lot is riding on this Lobato stage and the future of the company.
What? No. There's other things deciding that right now.
Starbreeze.
Yeah.
Are we a company?
Who knows what it's going to look like in 2-3 months.
We have our top men working on this.
Oh, that's awesome.
This concludes our dailies. Thank you, everybody.
What's going to be announced is that we have signed a letter of intent with Microsoft to acquire Double Fine. So Double Fine will be becoming part of Xbox Game Studios. Why this happened was a process that started, we were looking for extra funding for Psychonauts and talking to various investors. We've been sharing in this meeting, we've been talking to a lot of different investors. And when we talked to Microsoft, they're like, we don't really do that kind of thing, but what if we bought you guys? And and we're like, so flirty. And no, it's not really what we're about. We're a very independent studio. We've been independent for a long time. It's very important to us.
But it really sounds like from everything we've talked, all the conversations we've had with Xbox, that the team won't really feel too much of a change. They're really have this concept of an unplugged studio where they're kind of trying to stay out of people's way and like find developers that they, are excited about, that are making games that they're happy with, and just kind of let them do their thing.
Like, Microsoft really, really values Double Fine. Like, it was clear in their offer and everything they approached us and how they wooed the company. They really see a lot of value, and it's really a great recognition of everything that everyone here has been doing for the last 20 years.
I think we're all really excited about the stability that it'll bring.
But has this added any new clarity to the P2 schedule?
I mean, what it does mean for the P2 schedule is longer. I'd say longer than it was before, which was...
How much longer?
It doesn't mean that we run out when the Starbreeze money runs out, which is like months ago.
The game is going to get the attention that it needs and deserve.
And you guys are leaving, you leave tonight, tomorrow?
Yeah, so I leave tomorrow for LA, for E3. I've been doing like final scrambling of assets and builds and things. E3 is a special show for me. It was my first ever game show. 10 years ago, I met Tim at E3, the first day of E3, so that anniversary is coming up soon. And we've had a lot of really good ones. We've had a lot of, like, Tim and I have been in Microsoft press conferences before. I was, like, backstage playing Once Upon a Monster while he was out talking about it. But this definitely feels like it will be the biggest one we've ever done.
This is going to be announced on stage at E3, and I'm going to have to go out on stage and say something, and they didn't like my script, so I have to come up with a new script. I bought a Microsoft button-down shirt and everything, and they're just like, that's not funny. So nothing about us is going to change at all. I'm not listening to anything right now.
So I think it's still kind of setting in for all of us, and it probably won't be until we're down there in L.A., like about to go on that stage, that it all totally sinks in. But it's gonna be life-changing for him and for the studio and everybody.
This is good.
Hey! Pretty good. I don't know what I'll do with the part of my brain that we used to worry about money.
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Let's do it. Early.
Yeah, you know, we did a documentary about the making of the last game. We're doing a documentary about this one, too. And, oh my God, the camera's right there. Don't notice them.
Yeah, you're on it.
It's supposed to be about to me, showing people at the creative process and stuff. But whenever I'm being embarrassed, Paul always shows up to make sure it's captured. Whenever I'm getting my hair makeup done.
Yeah, and I would say inside by the boat. Well, and it might not be your thing. I mean, I'm just being thank you.
Thank you so much. We're going to announce the acquisition. The acquisition. I've never come to E3 this early before. Usually we come, just show up for 3 days, do a bunch of press and leave. This time we've been practicing all weekend. It's a big deal.
Figured.
Who's got a second on showdown? Looking good. You're distorting it with your muscles.
My sub pop coat.
Oh, that is so punk rock.
That's cool.
How do I look? Do I look like I have cream cheese? I just ate a bagel. My worst nightmare, I should not have eaten a bagel with cream cheese. Right before I go, I'm in costume. Believe it or not, this is my fancy outfit for going out on stage. Oh man, I'm only wearing one pair of socks. You gotta top me in every way. Every way, you're so competitive. Oh, how many pairs is Tim wearing? Just one? Okay.
I know, but you didn't get a note that your underwear lines were showing, so.
That was my call last night.
What are you even doing looking at that?
Oh, they look.
Good to see you again. Were you with us at 2002, E3 2002? Yeah, yeah, and we went to E3 2002. We went best of E3.
Yeah.
And I was there when you guys used to be in the garage.
Yeah. Okay.
I was talking to Greg about that. And so that was crazy.
Yeah.
And you like have to step over everyone coming in the door in the morning.
Yeah. And look how it's all come full circle. There here we are at E3 with Psychonauts again.
I know. So excited. I was like, it's very fun. You excited?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah. It's going to be crazy. People are going to, I don't know what people are going to think, but it'll be something. I've been calling people. Just last minute notifications to people like Chris Brown and Peter McConnell. And I can't get a hold of Peter Chan. I'm trying to tell Peter Chan, and before he finds out, I don't want him to find out in the news. I'm going to make a phone call. I'll be hiding in the corner making phone calls. Sorry. There's no more quiet corners of this room now. There's so many people in it. Well, no, the news is that we're getting acquired. We're getting acquired. We're getting bought by Microsoft. Yeah. It's going to be great. It's going to be fun. It actually makes me feel excited about coming up with creative ideas again of my own, like being able to run a project without, I won't have to do any more biz dev. Like, I won't have to do any more pitching. I won't have to do any more traveling road shows, you know, and asking for permission for things. We could just make fun games and then just tell them what we're doing and put them up. It would be great.
I just think I love the circle of the whole thing. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's very cool.
Yeah. Now we just
need to get down to the studio at some point.
Now we just have to wait. I want to go out on stage now and get this thing done. I'm just tired now. I'm tired. I'm going to mess it up on stage. I'm going to blow my lines. Oh, God. Oh, God. Keep it together. Keep it secret. Keep it safe. It's almost over. It's almost happening. So close.
So close. You guys are
43 minutes in. Oh, I just want to do it now. Can we just do it now and film it?
Copy. Everyone, Tim wants to go now.
Okay. We got to start with Tim. He's antsy.
Tim's first.
One. There's us.
E3 2019.
Had to come out after Keanu Reeves. It was fine.
Honored today to announce that joining Xbox Studios is Double Fine Productions. Please join me in welcoming the founder and president of Double Fine Productions, Tim Schafer.
Thank you so much, and thank you, Matt. We are so excited to be joining Xbox Game Studios, and I'm here to personally reassure you, Matt, I don't know what you've heard, but I'm a team player. Whatever you need from Double Fine, we'll make for you. Halo stuff, Forza stuff, Excel stuff, whatever you want, we are there. Yeah.
Tim, we just want you to make great games.
Oh, that's such a relief, because I was totally lying. In that case, we brought a brand new trailer for Psychonauts 2. Take a look if you dare.
shit.
Show begins,
we
get to see cool stuff.
You should buy
then some
we
chairs. We're gonna play the game all the time.
Nice. Hey! Awesome. People are gonna start showing up here in 10 minutes. So I want to let everybody know what's going on. That's the key, is you want to set the buzz early in the week with all the big outlets so that then people are coming throughout the rest of the week. I think we're about to get going.
Do we have the first group?
They're almost there, yeah.
Okay.
Happy E3, everybody. It's begun. Yeah. Officially, yeah.
So are you guys mostly media or other things too? Media? Psychonauts, as you remember, is an action-adventure platformer. Action-advention. That's how you can tell it's the first demo. And so their first mission, the Psychonauts will do what they do best, which is to do kind of a Mission Impossible-type heist inside the mind. Okay, so, yep. Great.
All right. Maybe.
This is the first puzzle in the game.
Get it started.
We want to make sure people really know what they're doing.
Yeah, we get Aaron.
Welcome to the world of E3 demos. Something that was working 5 minutes ago.
Yeah, exactly. So like we get everything set up and we were testing everything and getting everything calibrated and like, okay, we got everything running well. And then Tim goes in to run the first demo and like a minute later, someone comes out and grabs me like, Aaron, the controller doesn't work. And Tim's like,
right from the beginning.
Hey everybody, this is a programmer. We're gonna get everything figured out.
One of our fine programmers, the Double Fine.
Yeah, it keeps popping up and losing it. Do you want me to grab one? Turns out we had a couple of USB extension cables chained together and the computer didn't like that too well. Anyway, easy to fix.
Oh. 3 days ago.
All right, we're in.
And I did a few demos for the press. The early ones for the press were very, you know, they're very factually based, stoic, writing down things like regrets, doubts.
Why are you taking so long? I don't think you understand the gravity of the situation.
That's a metaphor for our demo experience.
It's kind of interesting. You have the like all the press and media people go through, and they're basically like stone-faced the entire time. It's kind of terrifying to go through and watch them play.
They want to keep that like I'm remaining impartial kind of vibe. So this is a little weird having people write their articles about the game you're live demoing, but whatever.
But at the end, Truman Zanotto, who is the grand head of the Psychonauts, sorry, the camp is run by the Psychonauts. I told that's really important and I just forgot about that. I'm sorry. I feel like I'm just biffing it, making the company look bad.
But it's really interesting. Like there's a huge difference between watching the press or media sit through one of the playthroughs versus fans.
Has anyone played the first Psychonauts game before? Oh my god, so many of you! One guy who I loved from last night, I asked if anybody played it, and he was just like, you weren't even born then. And I'm like, yeah, no, I've been born.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
It's nice. It is like, I'm so used to doing these for the press, where people are just like, mm-hmm. You guys are a much more smiley bunch. Well, welcome to our demo, and thanks for coming to check out Psychonauts 2. Raise your hand if you play the first game. Anyone play the first game? Okay. And then we did some for fans, and they were much more boisterous and loud and laughing at things, and that was really fun.
Think we should burn it?
Oh, you haven't changed, have you?
But then you have a group of fans come in and they get all excited and they laugh at all the jokes and they get excited when the characters are reintroduced and there's new enemies and all that kind of stuff. So that part's pretty great.
Yay, thanks for watching. Yay. So. Yay, great. Well, cool, I hope you like that. And right after then, Raz dies and the game goes into a dream sequence. No, Raz wakes up and he's on the jet with Dr. Lobato. Hi. All right, thank you. Woohoo! Thanks for coming, everybody. Hello! Hey!
You guys. This is so amazing. This is such a huge thing.
Is it? Scott Campbell came up.
What? It's real life. That's amazing.
Whoa.
That's amazing.
3D. Isn't that great? Like we always hoped and dreamed.
Wait, that's exactly what it was supposed to be.
Yeah. That was good, so fuck off.
Which guy said?
The guy in the front, so there you go. No, I think it
Yeah, it looks great, dude.
I'll cover up my microphone. You want to say what do you really think about the art?
Thumbs down, loose work. No.
Oh, Chris Brown came by, and Nikki Rapp, who does the voice of Lily. She's a great friend of ours, and she came by, and it was so nice to see her, and because she lives in L.A., so it was nice to come down here and see her. And then Steven Stanton also lives down here, does the voice of Sasha 9. He came by, and he actually got to watch the demo, and that was fun.
Everybody who's anybody in the gaming world is here. I think I just saw Larry Nintendo.
Psychonauts 2, woo! We got nominated for some awards.
Oh, we got another one.
Thank
you. Okay.
Hello, hello. Anybody?
Are the prices before or after tax?
Uh-oh. Are these someone's classes? It's been going amazing. Like, people coming out of the demo are saying, like, a lot of awesome stuff to us, and they all want shirts and pins.
Did you want a Raz pin as well, or did you want just the powers?
Yeah, and E3 exclusives this year are the Blacklight poster and the cover art print.
I'm sitting out here running merch stuff. And all of a sudden we see like all the lights in the entire convention center flicker for a second. I'm like, oh, that's weird. Wait a minute. I go open the door to the demo thing and sure enough, like everything is shut down and dead. I'm like, oh, crap. So we had to, you know, whoever was in there, we had to usher them out. And then we figured, okay, we'll just boot everything back up, it'll be fine, and get back in there. And the TV is drawing like every other line of pixels is like this solid black line, and yeah.
We have another HDMI cable.
So I had my laptop with me, I rushed my laptop in there and like plug things in, trying to figure out like what has failed, what is broken. And was real nervous there for a moment that I was gonna have to like call in someone to go run down to like the nearby Target and buy us a new TV or something. After finagling with the sound system and resetting it a couple times, it eventually sorted itself out.
Yay!
I did it!
But yeah, I'm guessing it was like a power surge or something, and something in the sound system did not like that.
There is a power surge. Sam's stoked about the power surge. There was like a loud like, but we still have power.
You know, Jack's such a lovely person, you know, and his family's fun, and they were very inclusive, let us hang out in their dressing room with them, including my entourage that showed up behind me. I looked around and was like, why are there four people behind me? Oh, I'm going to Jack's dressing room, that's why.
Hey, Jim's friends and associates.
There's one more.
Smash burger.
You're not going to show me eating a hamburger with Jack Black, are you?
But the tour is great, right?
Funny, yeah. Okay, is it time to go? Do you guys, I think it's time for us to go on stage.
Oh my God.
Did Bill Gates wine and dine ya?
I didn't want to name drop, but yeah. It took multiple dinners in the wallet. We got invited to the Xbox Employee Appreciation Party, which felt funny because we're like, wow. Employees. I mean, I guess a lot of people have been employees but me. And now I was like, employees. That was really nice because we got to meet a lot of people from the other companies like Ninja Theory. And I saw some old friends that work on the Forza team from LucasArts and LucasArts Days. I mean, yeah, it was very warm and welcome. We've had catered food before. Big deal. Not impressed, Microsoft.
Social bar is. Going up and down. That's good.
Sleeping is not a crime. Sleeping is not a crime. If I could, I'd sleep all day.
I mean, I'm ready to go home.
Bother me some other time. Bother me some other time. I don't care. Please go away.
There's a creep behind me.
Give me reason to get up in the morning.
It's a hard show. Like, it doesn't look hard, but when you come and do it, it's tiring, you know? Just, it's a lot of being always on, like talking to people and standing up and, you know, working on things.
I'm about to pass out, so it's good to keep running.
We just received it.
I could use a cup of coffee. Tucker's been playing well. We you almost missed it, but it added a little tension. Enjoy your last moments of E3.
And then we got a bunch of awards. You saw we got nominations and awards from different media outlets for the game, and the team got to see that, and that was nice.
Just received another award.
Oh, what a stage.
Best
Shaq News! Best teeth! Best teeth, Shaq News.
Right, we're
best teeth.
Best outlet.
That's awesome. Best what?
We won the best teeth of show from Shaq News, so job done. It's nice to have all those nominations and awards up there. I don't think we've ever had that many for a thing, so it's cool. I even know who some of them are.
Best teeth.
Hi. The game looks amazing.
What?
The game looks amazing.
Oh, you saw the demo. Awesome. Yeah. Thanks for watching. Thanks for watching.
The first one was awesome. So
oh, great.
Wait for this
one. Oh, that's awesome.
So it's quieting down, but you know the team's still here. We've sold out of shirts. We've sold out a bunch of other merch. Demos are still filling up, but it's going to be nice to just get out of here. Yeah, look at that creep. Yeah, it's been really, really good. I'm super glad we came, made our funny little booth, and yeah, it's been really, really, really good.
Now we're all relaxing. This is kind of our end of E3 party at the Airbnb we rented. Everyone's swimming or eating barbecue and chilling out by the fire pit. Oh God, this will help dry my swimsuits. But yeah, nothing but lovely things happened all week, so that was really nice.
Sleeping is not a crime.